When it comes to careers, it's ironic that something meant to bring fulfillment can actually become a major source of stress. As humans, we crave certainty, but figuring out what we want to do with our careers, or whether we'll truly enjoy them, can feel overwhelmingly uncertain. Even if you know exactly what you want, there's no guarantee you'll turn it into a successful, well-paying career, which only adds to the anxiety. This pressure translates into career anxiety, filling us with worries, self-doubt, and apprehension about whether we're on the right path or even fulfilled in our current jobs. I'll give you 5 tips that'll help you make the right choice. Tip 1, focus on tasks, not titles. One mistake many people make is getting too attached to job titles. Everyone wants to be a trader, an investment banker, or a doctor. They also tie these titles to a specific lifestyle, like being able to afford fancy vacations or luxury cars. But here's the thing, instead of focusing on what sounds glamorous, the real question is, what will you actually be doing every day? Will you enjoy those daily tasks? There are countless psychology studies showing that success in a career largely comes from enjoying the work. Professor Lorden's research highlights how focusing too much on the title can distract us from the actual day-to-day tasks involved. Personally, I used to think being a neurosurgeon or plastic surgeon would be cool, but after diving deeper, I realized it's the tasks that matter. It's about asking yourself, what will your day-to-day look like? Is it as glamorous as it sounds, or will it end up being a grind? Tip 2, visualize your me plus. One of the coolest concepts from the book is the idea of visualizing your me plus, the enhanced version of yourself that you aspire to be. To help with this, Professor Lorden has a great exercise you can try. Think about your me plus job title, the industry you'll be working in, the type of company, maybe your own, and the kind of responsibilities you'll have. Break it down further by listing the tasks you want your me plus to focus on. What would make you excited to go to work? I've done this exercise myself, and it helped me define the tasks I really enjoy, like solving problems, coaching others, or performing for the public. Once you know what those tasks are, you can start taking small steps to align your current career with your future goals. Tip 3, audit your time. Here's a practical step: audit how you're spending your time. Throughout the week, track what you're doing and ask yourself if these activities are helping you move toward your me plus or not. Do they give you purpose? Do they feel fun or fulfilling? An easy way to do this is by looking at your calendar. I like to screenshot mine and evaluate how each activity contributes to my goals. If something is a double plus, it means it's really pushing me toward my ideal career. If it's a plus, it's somewhat helpful. A plus minus means it's neutral, and a double minus is something that's actively wasting my time. Over time, you'll want to eliminate those double minuses and focus on tasks that bring you closer to your me plus. Tip 4, the 13-minute rule. Building the career you want takes investment, but it doesn't have to consume your life. Professor Lorden suggests committing just 90 minutes a week, or 13 minutes a day, to developing the skills that'll move you toward the career you want. That could be learning a new skill like coding, or honing a craft you're already good at. It's not about becoming an expert overnight, but about compounding small, consistent efforts. As Cal Newport, the author of Deep Work and So Good They Can't Ignore You, explains, building career capital is essential. You earn the career you want by developing rare, valuable skills. Those small 13-minute investments will pay off as they compound over time. Tip 5, you don't always need to go back to school. If you're unsure about your career path, don't rush into a 4-year degree or an expensive master's program. These days, you can learn almost anything online for free or at a fraction of the cost. Now, I'm not saying traditional education is worthless. In fact, I've benefited from my degree. but if you're already in your career or exploring new interests, there's a wealth of resources available without stepping into a classroom. Finally, if you're still unsure what your dream career looks like, adopt the grid search mindset. You don't need to have everything figured out all at once. Instead, start by identifying the activities you enjoy, whether it's teaching, entrepreneurship, or creative work, and see how your current path aligns with those interests.